Christ, of the priesthood, the deacons in Christ, from the clergy and the people, and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Yeah. πιστεύειν αντελώνα και εκ του καρπού αυτού που καισθεί. Η της ποιμένη πίνη και εκ του γάλακτος της πίνης που καισθεί. Μη κατά άνθρωπο ταύτα λαλό. Η ούχη και ο νόμος ταύτα λέγει. Εγκάρτο Μωυσέως νόμο γέγραφε. Ου θυμώσεις βουν αλώνα. Μη τον πόν μέλη το Θεό. Η δι ημάς πάντως λέει. Δι ημάς γάρ εγγράφει. Ότι επελπίδει οφείλει ο αρωτριών αρωτριάν. Και ο αλών της ελπίδος αυτού μετέχει επελπίδει. Η ημίς ημίς τα πνευματικά εσπήρανε. Μεγά εις ημίς ημών τα σαρκικά θερίσωνε. Η άλλη της εξουσίας ημών μετέχουσι. Ου μάλλον ημίς αλλούν εκκρισάνεθα τη εξουσία ταύτη. Αλλά πάντα στέγουμε ή να μη εκτοπίν την αδόμη το Ευαγγελίο του Χριστού.
Την ίση, let us be attentive.
The Lord is my strength and my soul. The Lord has chosen me. Sword.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians.
Let us be attentive.
Brother, you are the seal of my apostleship in the Lord. This is my defense to those who would examine me. Do we not have right to our food and drink? Do we not have the right to be accompanied by wife as other apostles and the brothers of the Lord in Cephas? Or is it only Barnabas, I who have no right to refrain from working for a living, who serves as a soldier at his own expense, who plants a vineyard without eating any of its fruits, who tends a flock without getting some of the milk? Do I say this under human authority? Does not the law say for the same? For it is written in the law of Moses, you shall not muzzle an ox when it strikes on the grain. It is for the oxen that God is concerned. Does he not speak entirely for our sake? It was written for our sake because the plowman should plow in hope and the thresher thresh in hope of share in the crop. And we have sown spiritual good among you. Is it too much if we reap your material benefits? If brothers share this right of claim upon you, do not we still more? Nevertheless, we have not made use of this right, but we endure anything rather than put an obstacle in the way of the gospel of Christ.
Peace be unto you, the reader. Oh, there will said to his disciples, the kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who wished to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the reckoning, one was brought to him who owed him 10,000 talents. As he could not pay, his lord ordered him to be sold with his wife and children and all that he had, and payment to be made. So the servant fell on his knees, imploring him, Lord, have patience with me, and I will pay you everything. And out of pity for him, the lord of that servant released him and forgave him the debt. But that same servant, as he went out, came upon one of his fellow servants who owed him 100 denarii, and seizing him by the throat, he said, pay what you owe. So his fellow servant fell down and besought him, have patience with me, and I will pay you. He refused and went and put him in prison till he should pay the debt. When his fellow servants saw that the debt had taken place, they were greatly distressed, and they went and reported to their lord all that had taken place. Then his lord summoned him and said to him, you wicked servant, I forgave you all that debt because you besought me. And should not you have mercy on your fellow servant as I have mercy on you? And in anger his lord delivered him to the jailers till he should pay all of his debt. So also my heavenly Father will do every to one of you if you do not forgive your brother his trespasses from $100. This gentleman owned $100, so basically $1,000. And he goes to the servant in the same manner that he went to his Lord. And the person says, again, the same word in Greek that shows for mercy and patience, and goes to them, please, have patience with me. Have mercy with me. I will repay you everything. And his actions were essentially the antithesis, the exact opposite of what the Lord has shown him. He literally grabs him by the throat and tells him, you're going to pay me what you owe. Now everyone around is witnessing this and they're saying, you are the same guy who just got relieved of 10,000 talents. This guy owes you, in comparison, next to nothing. Remember, 10,000 talents. 10,000 of like 1 million. So that's $10 billion, basically, if my math is correct. And this guy's arguing for this guy for $1,000? How ridiculous does that sound? Yes, Papa, that sounds ridiculous. This guy just basically gained all of that pressure off of his shoulders and goes and does the exact opposite. Being in debt in those days was very significant. More significant than it is in today's time. Financial stress is probably one of the greatest stresses in people's lives. It stresses relationships, it stresses individuals, it stresses young adults, and so on. Being financially, I guess you could say, savvy, having the know-how on your personal finances and so on, is in a sense liberating for some. When they do figure it out. There's many different programs and so on. I encourage you, of course, to all be some type of level of personal finance, financial saving. If you need help, we can figure it out. But the freedom that comes from that is significant. Now, back then, it's even more significant. It's not just about, can I afford to have a car? Can I afford to have this? Can I afford to this? Or what might seem as basic needs? Back then, if you were in debt to somebody, they could literally imprison you and your entire family. Imagine everyone who has a credit card in today's time being sent to jail. There'd be no one to roam the earth. But that's how insane this is. But that's how significant it was. And the mercy that was shown, not just to not have the debt on that man's shoulders, in that man's life, but the pressure of knowing I went into debt knowing that my family could possibly be in prison. His wife, his children. Trust me, you would probably think twice about being in debt if those were the stipulations, if that was in the fine print. So there's multiple lessons in this parable. There's don't go into debt. And I don't just mean money. I mean when you think of what an interaction is in a relationship. If we sin or do something wrong against somebody else, we are in debt to them. We owe them something. Something called an apology. We have to ask for forgiveness. And if, let's say, they did something wrong against us, and that was the reaction, our behavior was the reaction to someone doing something wrong with us, we have to forgive. I've spoken about this before. I know you are aware, I'm going to repeat myself. In the Lord's Prayer, you ask for the Lord to forgive your trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. So I want you to, again, in the similar fashion that I asked months ago, use the imagery of what you said. You're asking God to forgive your sins the way you forgive other people. If you are really bad at forgiving, this is your time to change that. Because the way you forgive is the way God is going to forgive you. Let that resonate with you for a little bit. The way you forgive is the way God is going to forgive you. The way you show mercy to other people, God will show mercy. The way that you show patience to other people, God is going to show mercy to you. completely changes your whole mindset as to how we behave. Because now we're going to leave today with a greater knowledge of ourselves and how we behave, and self-reflection, and how we impact others through our behaviors, through our lack of forgiveness. Nowhere in here does it say, well, they took the money, it's their fault. I know, because I read it, and then I summarized it, and now I'm telling you it definitely didn't happen. So no one ever said, point your finger at the other person because that's okay. No, because it's not okay. It's not a lesson in the parable because it's not a lesson that we should be following. So think of the behaviors that are here. Think of the mercy that the Lord shared, the patience that the Lord shared to his servant, to someone who works for him, who owed him a massive, significant amount of money. That's how we need to behave. Now, people aren't owing us money or this or that, but like I said, in relationships, we might say words. There might be an exchange of actions, favors, or this or that. Relationships are not transactional. If you have relationships that are transactional, they are useless. I know you heard because I just yelled it and I have a microphone on. They are useless. They don't help you. There's no significant empowerment or any type of growth that is going to happen in a transactional relationship. Because it is always going to be based on the transaction. In this gospel, we are given an example of what a transactional relationship looks like. The person who was just given that significant amount of money to relieve from themselves, that lord, for lack of better terms, that person in that position, to the other individual who owed him the 100 denarii, that's a transactional relationship. That relationship is, you did this, you borrowed this, I need you to give me this, and has nothing to do with the sake of the other person's growth, for the sake of the other person's care, love, mercy, patience, kindness, all the words, all the different. But in the example of the first relationship to the Lord, to the servant, who owed him 10,000 talents, you see all of those things. And this is someone who owed him a significant amount of money. Or someone who might have done something significant against you. Or someone who might have said really hurtful things against you and let it trickle down. And the reaction is I'm going to forgive. And the word that's used is the same word of forgiveness that we speak about in that Lord's Prayer. The last time I spoke in this way of forgiveness, I challenged everyone, if someone did something wrong against you, and it was over 3 years ago, get over it. That challenge still stands. So if you haven't done it yet, I'm going to repeat myself. If someone did something against you and it happened over 3 months ago, sorry, 3 years ago, see, I'll show mercy, all right? Three years is a lot. Get over it. Because guess what? The only person who has the weight on their shoulders is you. You are putting that pressure on yourself, holding that angst, that frustration, that anxiety, that worry. So now, if you were someone who were here 5 months ago when I said that challenge, if you haven't done it, you know what to do. I just said it. If you didn't, now it's time to grow. If you did forgive somebody who did something wrong against you over 3 years, now it's time, if something's happened in the last year or more, it's time to forgive them. Because now you've held all of that pressure, all of that weight, all of that worry, all of that anxiety upon yourself. And it's time to free yourself of that debt.
of that pressure, of that weight. And how do you do it? We heard it today. You show mercy. You forgive, this level of forgiveness. And just to summarize, the word that is used is, the general word is aphemen in Greek, which means, and translates into English, as if it never happened again. So, a life example in the parable of being forgiven as if it never happened again. This man who was forgiven 10,000 talents doesn't owe the man a dime anymore, as if he never borrowed the money. That is how we have to forgive. As if this event never happened, because even if it happens again and again and again, we have to forgive again and again and again. And that is on us in our spiritual maturity. And the maturity to be able to say, I am not going to let this affect me. My heart has compassion on that individual, and I no longer want to hold this weight upon me. So, if you haven't done it yet, 3 years and above, forget it. Forgive it. If you did that last time, as I'm sure you saw, it was liberating. Very frustrating, I'm sure, but it was liberating down the line. I want you to do it again if something's happened in the last year. Because holding on to that frustration and anger doesn't get you anywhere. And more importantly, it doesn't help your relationship with God. And so we have to look at all of this, our relationships, the debts and the weight of which we have on our shoulders, and see how it affects our life. So we no longer behave like this man does. Because as we're given in that last sentence of today's gospel, the Son of Man is to be delivered into the hands of men. Sorry, that was from the one before. But that the Father will do to every one of you if you do not forgive your brother or sister in his trespasses from your heart. From your heart. That's where all of this is going to come. You hold all of the keys. It's on you now. Decide to forgive. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you. Sosum fios to malos, to kebunis, to kebunis, to kebunis, to kebunis, to kebunis, to kebunis, to
Through the prayers of the holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ.
to reflect about how we can incorporate the major feasts of our church, the saints' days, and so on, more into our lives, between whether it's focusing on the daily readings app or things like that, our prayer schedule of our services, to be able to come to as many of them that we can. We will be having more services, especially as the year goes on, so please join us. We're trying to offer also some evening opportunities as well for those who are working. But this Wednesday, we do have one of our first major feast day. That is the Nativity of the Theotokos, which happens on September 8th. So this Wednesday, we will have Orthodox at 9 o'clock, and Divine Liturgy at 10 o'clock in the morning. I know for those who are working, but you'll be able to at least tune in on our YouTube channel to be able to participate with us. Even while you're at work, just put it on some earphones or something like that. It would be a great opportunity. Over the last few weeks, we've been asking for people to volunteer during the week to have our church open for prayer. I am ecstatic to announce that we are 4 of the 5 days away. All the days but Monday are, everyone's got a case of Mondays, I guess. Every day but Monday is days we're going to be volunteered for. So Tuesday on, the church will be open from 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock every single day for people to come during their lunch hours or however they want to schedule it for prayer, which will be a great blessing and opportunity. I hope people take advantage of it. I hope people that might be working by will be able to take advantage of having that opportunity. So our church will be open for prayer, just the opportunity for a little peace, some ECP on our lives. So again, we'll start, regardless of having the entire week or not, we'll be starting in the next few weeks. We're going to meet first, and then be able to kind of get some connections down, and then we will begin. I will announce to you on Sunday when the week begins, and hopefully by then maybe we'll get someone for Monday. If you still have the opportunity to come on Monday, or at least some Mondays, it's okay. I know it's a big commitment to come every single week for one day, for those hours 10 to 2, but if you have the ability to, we would love for you to have it open so that we can offer it to our community. With that being said, John, please come up. John would like to make an announcement in regards to our Christmas program.
Good morning, everyone. First of all, we'd like to welcome Petros Kitsas and his family, not just our community, but also Petros joined our choir today. The Kitsas family moved down here, we moved here to Puerto Rico. We're very excited about having Petros in our choir family. Also, I want to talk very briefly about the Christmas pageant. And we started off with a holiday, big holiday pop show production, but you know, due to COVID restrictions, we're still going to have, I think it's important that we do something musical for the community and the community abroad, so at large. So we're going to like really have, we're playing a beautiful Christmas pageant. What I mean by that is we've gotten the light, you see the light, you see that. Again, if you remember from here a couple of years ago where we put together the Christmas pageant, it was complete with dance, music, song. So we're going to try to get like that, a little bit twist on that, actually a lot of twist on that. And so adults will be playing adults, children will be playing children in the production. And so everyone is welcome to join their singing parts, non-singing parts, speaking parts, non-speaking parts. We'll be hosting in the hall because I was given some extra liberties, whichever artistic liberties, whichever you can take upon. And so so everyone is welcome. I'd like to see at least one person from every family in this community. We already get it only first come, first serve for seating. It's a free production that we're doing. It will be a production. And it's a free production. We also have I have a bus already coming from Newport Ritchie to for the Greek church that decided to come in. It will be first come, first serve in that hall for that event. And so also we're asking for any type of donations, whether you can help build sets, help work in getting some costumes from a community church in Pasadena. It used to host a living nativity. So hopefully I'll be able to get a lot of your costumes. And we're going to retell the story in a really dramatic way. And I guarantee you, it will be very dramatic. So support them when you can. We're asking any type of donation you might be able to acquire. We have a couple of fundraisers, to defray some of the costs. We will have instruments, trumpets, flutes. It will be a wonderful production, costumes. And so again, the date is December 4th at 6 o'clock sharp. It's an hour, maybe 15 minute total production. There will be a reception afterwards, but if it feels comfortable, if you'd like to stay, you can, based on, again, the COVID restrictions. If you're comfortable about being at the reception, great. If not, it's open. So, and it's open to the community at large. So there will be other members of our community. outreach program to come and see our Christmas pageant. A lot of churches are this year. I just brought a lot of my friends musically in there. No, Christmas is not to celebrate not just with our traditional Christmas school pageant children, but the whole community embraces Christ. This is a great way that I think we can bring everyone together in our community and our community at large with other denominations that will be joining. So please help bring to me a wonderful production. Thank you.
Thank you, John. God bless you all. We hope to see you throughout the week.